ओके जेमेन, वेलकम बैक टू माय वीडियोस। दिस इज एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द लास्ट वीडियो दैट आई हैड टॉक्ड अबाउट, वेयर आई हैड टू कंप्लीट द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दीज टू आइटम्स दैट वेयर पेंडिंग इन द लास्ट वीडियो। सो लेट्स फर्स्ट गो फॉर cos of 74 degrees। You can see that this angle 74 degrees lies between 60 degrees and 90 degrees. And the difference between the 74 degrees and 60 degrees is 14 degrees. So we cannot use this difference of 1 degree in case of this 14 degrees. We would go how much? 14 times. So that would be a very long process. We have to find a value of this cos function which is near to this 74 degrees, and from that we can very well calculate the value of cos 74. The 74 degree is made by 30 degrees plus 45 degrees. And the cos function for two angles is given by cos of 30 degrees into cos of 48 degrees minus sine of 30 degrees into sine of 45 degrees. That would give us cos 30 is root 3 by 2 into cos 48 is 1 by root 2 minus sin 30 is half into sin 48 is 1 by root 2. So it comes out to be 2 root 2, we can take common and in the bracket root 3 minus 1. That's easier. That becomes 1 by 2 root 2 0.732 gives 0.2588. So we have to write down the value of cos 78. Cos of 74 degrees would be equal to cos of 75 degrees plus change in cos function due to minus 1 degree 0.2588 plus minus of sin theta, so theta 75 into 2 pi by 360 negative 0.2588 plus 0.9659 into 2 pi by 360 0.2756 cos 74 degrees. So we will check it in the calculator. Cos 74. Okay, it's perfect. 0.2756. Okay, the next is tan inverse 0.95. What it means is that theta should be such that tan theta would be equal to 0.95. 0.95 is close to 1, where the theta becomes 48 degrees. Okay, so this we can take the reference to find out this. Okay, we have to reach to this 0.95 from 1. For 1 it is 45 degrees, and for 0.95 we have to find out the value. There is a gap of how much? 0.05. The deviation of the functions are dependent on the derivative or the rate of change of that function at any angle. And rate of change of tan function, that is equal to sec square theta 1 plus tan square theta. It changes at the square of that initial value. So it will go in steps of very small values. So we'll have to split it up in two parts, 0.025 plus 0.025. Now we'll take a difference of 0.025 first. That means next would be 0.975. Now, let me explain you one thing. That is, let's say y is a function of x, okay? That means dy by dx is equal to, say, something. Dy is equal to k dx. K is what? That is rate of change of y. So let's write y prime, okay? So dy becomes y prime into dx. Now what will be dx? Dx would be equal to dy upon the y prime, or the rate of change of y. This formula is to be put here. The dx, or the change in the angle, would be equal to the change in the value of the function divided by the rate of change. That means d theta will be equal to change in that function, that is 0.025, by the rate of change of that function, tan function, 1 plus tan square theta. What was the tan theta initially? It was 1. So it will be 0.025 divided by 1 plus 1 square, or equal to 0.025 by 2, which is equal to 0.0125. That is in radians, or in degrees will be 0.71619 degrees. For 0.975, angle is 45 degrees minus 0.71619. That is equal to 44.2838 degrees. Now I have to find out for 0.95. d theta would be equal to change. That means again 0.025 divided by 1 plus 10 square theta for that this angle, 0.975 square. This multiplied by the degrees in, that would be in degrees. This gives 0.7343 degrees. Now this we have to reduce from this, so it makes 44.2838 minus 0.7343, 43.549 degrees. 10 43.549. You can see 0.950 and 49. That is the value of tan inverse 0.95. Let me just give you a short idea about where this formula can be in use. A mass is placed over a inclined surface with an angle of theta. The value of that angle at which the mass would slide down on its own, tan theta, should be equal to mu, the coefficient of friction. So in that case, this kind of formula will come into help to find out the theta here. And what about these things? say you have a mass hanging here supported by two wires. The weight of the mass will be balanced by the vertical components of this tension, that means T2 cos theta 2, and for T1 it will be T1 cos of theta. They make the weight of the mg. The horizontal components of these two individual tensions have to be cancelled out for equilibrium. That means T2 sin theta 2 should be equal to T1 sin theta 1. From this you can very easily find out the values of T1 and T2. So I think you must have got an idea, and this video has been a great benefit to you. So thanks for watching. See you in the next video, where the next video will be again a interesting one. See you soon in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.